Performance-wise, Aztec is locked at your monitor's refresh rate, but the devs have told me that animations only go up to 120 frames per second, so it's a little less than the title's average of 142 FPS. Not ideal, but it's far from unacceptable, and it makes up for this with the lack of any stutters or crashes whatsoever, though I am still disappointed at the lackluster options menu. Aztez is Team Colorblind's attempt at a unique hybrid between a beat-em-up and a turn-based strategy title. So the rating of this review is going to hinge on how satisfying the brawling is and how well it's incorporated into the game's strategic elements. Combat-wise, it sticks to the core concept of a single character fighting off multiple enemies, each of which fall into 8 to 9 types of foes that all have different attack patterns and weapons. The diversity in the enemy fighting styles parallels your own changing movesets when you acquire new weapons in the campaign. But for now, let's assume that you have all 4 weapon slots filled. The effectiveness of fighting mechanics is largely dependent on depth and execution. You can either promote player choice and fluid combat by giving people access to a ton of combos, or by contrast, you could compensate for only having a few button prompts by making engagements more reflex-based and almost rhythmic in nature. The devs have stated their intentions to be more like Bayonetta, so we'll judge the game from that first perspective. Aztez incorporates most of the expected mechanics of the genre, so that includes multiple weapons, switching between those weapons in the middle of combos, dashes with invincibility frames, and blocks that allow for counterattacks if timed precisely. However, the fundamental attacks themselves is where the game fails to provide an engaging experience. You have the standard two types of attacks done through the square and triangle buttons respectively, but mixing between both inputs doesn't bring you much combo diversity. A full combo in this game features 5 hits. Here is the combo with 5 square inputs. Now this is the combo with 5 triangle inputs. Notice when I mix them up, it doesn't result in any new combos. Instead, it just transitions from the 5 square combo to the 5 triangle combo at the point of transition. The distinct lack of any variation in this sense becomes apparent after the first few fights, and it sets the tone for the rest of the game. Now add to that the fact that both square and triangle attacks do the same amount of damage, and what you have is an implication that there's no benefit to mixing and matching your combos, since you're always stuck to that 5-hit limit per weapon. The only thing that really allows for combo variation is when you swap between weapons in the middle of attacks, since this allows you to restart the hit counter, making it very easy to juggle your foes endlessly. While other games like Devil May Cry also feature that juggle possibility through weapon swapping, executing it isn't nearly as simple as the single button input that's required in Aztez. The fact that newer weapons introduce different movesets doesn't really matter at this point, since the game never gives you a compelling enough reason to divert from its spammy playstyle. Criticisms aside though, Aztez does do some things right, namely with its enemies, since each of them employs a different sort of moveset to match their associated weapons. While you do get notification prompts of when they're about to strike, they're able to choose from one of 2 possible attack patterns from that point, both of which require different parry timings to deflect properly. The game does well in making them telegraph which pattern they're going to go for, so you do have to be attentive to more than just the exclamation points, and things can get pretty challenging when 4 different types of enemies attack you at once. Besides this though, dealing enough damage brings foes to what is called a broken state, whereby grabbing them and hitting them with the attack button will lead to a fountain of blood spurting out of their bodies. You can absorb this blood to fill up the vial in the top left, and when that's full, you can perform a god attack that changes depending on the god you have equipped. These mechanics bring a nice bit of change to the monotony of combat, but the fact of the matter is that they aren't strictly crucial to winning fights, meaning that you'll still be relying on the tried and true aerial spam. With most of the combat out of the way, we can get into the game's turn-based campaign. Laid out on the board are many Mesoamerican cities, and the objective is to defeat the Spanish forces that appear on turn 10 before they conquer the rest of your land. The amount of resources you get at the end of every round depends on the cities currently under your control, and you do have skills to allow you to conquer other locations at the cost of said resources. Your turn will consist of carrying out as many missions as you have soldiers to gain the benefits of victory. Sometimes this rewards you with resources, an item card, or even a new weapon. It really depends on the random mission that pops up, and each of them have optional conditions you can fulfill for more positive effects. I think the campaign works well as a basic strategy game, but not much beyond that. The item cards can be fun to use, and the optional conditions set a small degree of challenge, but there's never any moment where you'd have to make a tough decision in which mission to prioritize. It usually boils down to what benefit you'd rather get, and the lack of depth in this strategic element means that the campaign isn't compelling enough to make you forget its underlying repetitive nature, especially since all missions force you to fight a wave of enemies. It's hardly what I would consider a single player with high replay value, and that's even considering the addition of arena mode that pits you against multiple waves of enemies in quick succession. Aztez doesn't exactly pop in its visual presentation, partly because of the sheer amount of white, black, and grey in the scenes, and also since the enemies at hand don't give you much time to appreciate the decent background variation. It's definitely committed to a theme, but there's nothing much else outstanding about it, and these sentiments extend to the audio as well. Background music usually comprises of rhythmic drums and strings to get you into that fighting mood, but since each combat phase lasts only a couple minutes or so, you never get the time to fully immerse yourself into it. Overall, I wasn't impressed here either. Aztez has some of the makings of a compelling brawler, like the ability to cancel jumps or transition from hits to blocks very quickly, but it fails to provide enjoyable gameplay in its fundamental mechanics. Its repetitive nature diminishes the replay value, and that's something that can't be outshined by the few good things it accomplishes. So I'd only recommend getting it at $10, maybe $12. And that's me done for this review. Thank you so much for your time. Please subscribe if you feel so inclined, and if you enjoyed the video, please leave a positive rating on the Steam review linked in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks again, and I'll see you next time.